Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Enter the Gungeon. I'm Stealwing 33, and today we're going to be playing as the pilot, and we're going to be using the alternate costume for the pilot today. He's got a fluffy coat and some sort of, like, cool Geordi LaForge visor going on. On the last episode, we managed to beat, spoiler alert if you haven't watched it yet, but you really should go back and watch it. It's an hour long for a reason, people. We managed to beat the past as the hunter, and so now we have all of the pasts killed. So on this episode, we are going to try to go down to the what we unlocked for that. I don't want to tell you guys what it is, because I kind of want it to be a surprise. But it's basically a bonus level that takes place instead of us going to the past. I'm very excited. I'm super excited. I also have a couple other ideas for what to do after we, you know, inevitably beat this. First, we're going to try to beat it with every character, obviously. Like, that's, you know, paramount numero uno. But then, I found out, so, the hero statue, now that we've killed the past, which is that first statue at the beginning of the game over there, after you've beaten the past with a character, if you activate it with that character, you gain 9 curse. So what we're going to try to do at some point is do the massive overcurse run, where we activate the statue and try to beat the run with 9 curse. I think it'll be very exciting. I'm super excited to try to make that happen. We're doing alright so far. I mean, I've already taken a hit, but, you know, there's not a lot to go over as far as the progress of our little run here so far, but we'll get there. We'll get there at some point. Alright, we got cigarettes, the banana, 2 keys, and Locklear, who is selling the heart locket for 1 key. We will buy the heart locket for 1 key, because that is a price that I cannot pass up. I'd rather not have items and have an extra heart than have to do anything like that. That we'll be able to buy an extra key at some point on this floor, and we're playing as the pilot, so we do have access to the trusty lockpick, which if we get lucky enough, I'll actually, you know, help out a little bit here. But we'll see how that shakes out later. We'll be using the trusty lockpick on any brown chests that we come across. Brown chests are not normally worth it in the long run. Although there are plenty of items that spawn in brown chests that are pretty decent. In particular, there's stuff like the scope is pretty good. There are a series of guns that you can get. The blunderbuss comes out of brown chests. I think there are a lot of shotguns, a lot of more basic, mundane type weapons come out of brown chests, but they're weapons that I'm pretty decent with overall. But, you know, we'll see. We'll get there when we get there. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. That's sort of how you gotta play Gungeon, right? Cross that bridge when you get to it. What is this one? It's take curse for damage. Yes, take curse for damage. Easy peasy. I'm more than willing to take a little bit of curse in order to up my damage by what appears to be a significant amount. We're now 2-shotting Bulletkin instead of 3-shotting them. Nope, still 3-shotting them. Never mind. I lied. I wonder if that makes our damage go up as we accumulate curse. If we were doing a curse run, we wouldn't have been able to do that, by the way, because we would have had 9 curse, and doing that causes the Lord of the Jammed to show up, who's like, remember those Reaper guys? Imagine that, but like on every floor. He's kind of like the ghost from Spelunky, if you've ever played Spelunky. Yeah. Well, I think we're doing alright right now. We're mostly we're sitting pretty. I mean, I don't know. We'll see what the guns we get are, because that's really going to make or break us in the long run here, is what caliber of weaponry are we going to get on this first floor. And that's where a lot of, that's for me personally, like, you know, your mileage may vary. Some of you might be super good with the goddamn rogue special. I'm not, so, you know, I require various other weaponry in order to survive the game. Which, you know, again, that's on me. It's not like, that's not a problem with the game itself. It's a problem with the way that I play it. All right. Not too bad, though. I do like the pilot's costume, though. It's cute. I'd be interested in trying to make a cosplay out of this one. I like I think the Marines is probably my favorite, because I like medieval knights. the Marine's armor is. He looks like a guy from Castle Crashers a little bit. Oh, that's all right. My buddy Jack is messaging me. He just released a game today. Well, a game that he worked on came out today. It wasn't like his game. It was he was working on it through a publisher. And it is not doing favorably on Steam right now. Largely due to the fact that, you know, that's sort of just how life be sometimes, you know? Life is sweet. Alright, let's buy these keys, and then, Locklear, are you selling any guns? You are selling a ring of chest friendship, which I will buy. Is it because that was one key, right? Yep. And then we'll go back and get the blue chest, and hope that there's a weapon in here. It is the proximity mine. It is a weapon, so I guess I can't complain. But that is not what I was looking for. I was looking for a gun of some caliber. But I guess here we go. I bought the Ring of Chest Friendship largely due to the fact that, like, I knew... It's a future investment, right? So I got it specifically because I know later in the game it will be useful. And for no other reason. Alright, there we go. We're just gonna have to focus on dodging. And dodging well. That was a very risky dodge. Because if we can get through this without getting hit with just the Rogue Special, I'll be pretty pleased, actually, because I think that'll be a first. Especially specifically with the Rogue Special, that'll be a first. And there we go. I need to remember that using a blank near targets does cause them to get hurt. Ah, like, that guy almost got me. It got me! Recall that, like, I don't actually have a problem with the sidearms. I think that they're just not bad. They're just slow, like, in comparison. Even, like the M1911, which is a gun that's about comparable to your sidearm, except that it does the same amount of damage, but it shoots significantly faster. I think it has an uncapped fire rate, which is good. Again, don't get me wrong, like, we can do this, like, we're doing it right now. It's just a matter of trying to get it to happen here. We still have one blank left, but I want to try to save it for a situation where I'm definitely going to get hit. The fact that I didn't get hit during that last little charade was, you know, lucky, to say the least. I know, man, it's all skill. 100% grade A American skill. It's the American Dragon. Do-do-do-do-do-do. American Dragon. He's gonna stop his enemies with his dragon power. Dragon teeth, dragon tails, burning dragon fire. If you guys remember that show, that's a blast from the past. Is that the Aura Gunny? Sweet Jesus. I hate this gun so much. Man, all right, that's fine. Luma managed to beat the first floor boss with you just using the Rogue Special, so... And we got Mastery on it, which puts us at 5 hearts, 1 armor. We got the Aura Gunny now, so feeling a little less concerned. The Aura Gunny's still a garbage fire of a weapon. I'm still not pleased with it, but, you know, whatever. Who knows, maybe it's so much better now that we have that, like, one damage upgrade from the Curse Statue or something. I don't. I'm not a doctor. I mean, really, I should know. Like, I don't actually... I know that statue gives you curse up, but it also gives you damage up. But I don't know, like, how that scales, you know? Like, how much is a damage up actually worth? Like, in relation to... Like, if I still 3-shot regular-ass bullet kin on this floor with my Rogue Special, that means it was, like, a 0.5 damage up. Or something like that, I think. But we'll see. Because if every gun does, like, 1 damage, and you multiply it by... I don't actually know what you would multiply that by. I'm never very good at math. I'm still not very good at math. I'm a much better speaker, public speaker, and English I'm a good reader and a good writer. Those are my skill sets. Math, not one of my strong suits at all, actually. Quite the opposite. Actually, in general, the thing I'm the worst at is math. But, like, I can do basic math really easily. Basic multiplication, division, and subtraction. But, like, I don't remember how to really do percentages or decimals at all. Like, almost at all. Ah, well. Alright, I was trying not to get hit. That's why I used my blank there, but it turned out to be folly. So, I mean, there you go. It was folly to begin with, because I just shouldn't have done that. It's a room. You never use blanks on rooms. It's my own rule. I broke it. The napalm strike I'm interested in. That's an item that we literally just got. If I'm not mistaken, it's a bunch of explosions followed by fire. I mean, the name napalm strike suggests that. I've never used the item. I've actually never even seen it used. Ooh, heart of ice. 122, Jesus. Well, there's no keys on this room, this floor, so we will have cashish available to us for use on that. If we get kind of lucky, we're going to need to get some serious money drops in order to make that happen at all. But that's alright. We'll get there. I wonder if, like, you get burning, the burning bullets, hot bullets. If you get that plus, like, Oregon-y, if, like, you don't even fire bullets anymore. Or if you get, like, ice bullets plus Oregon-y, you shoot, like, wads of paper at people. That'd be kind of funny. It's like snot balls for, irradiated lead. Okay, deal with the ones that aren't jammed first, because they'll go down easier. Then deal with the jammed one. I just want to make sure that I'm able to dodge roll away from the jammed guy as much as possible. Live wire, American Dragon. I don't know why I got that show stuck in my head. I haven't actually watched that show in, God, better part of a decade. I think it's been like 8 years or so, something like that. I'm shocked I dodged those, by the way, with all that fancy footwork and the dancing around them I was doing. I was like, I'm gonna get hit, but I'm gonna keep trying to do this because I'm an idiot and I'm not gonna dodge roll. Just drop that there. Kill that guy. The proximity mine is not great, to say the least. The reason it's not great is because it's got too long of a cooldown. If it, like, auto-cooled down, basically, like, there are weapons that do that. It might be okay, but the cooldown on it's way too long. And you can't throw it, so you have to, like, place it down and just sort of kite people into it, which it has inherent risk with it. I think there are gunnies much better on rooms that are wider open than the ones we've been getting. We'll wait to see what the second chest is before we decide whether or not we're going to open up that blue one. Because if it's a green chest, I prefer to open that over trying to open up a blue chest. Green chests have a better item pool than the blue ones do. Not by much, mind you, but by enough. Red cape bulletkin man. Ow, please stop, rubber bullet. This is the best rubber bullet ever. Knocking me into pits and shit. This was not a fun room to fight the rubber bullet on at all. Oh, come on. Don't give me that. Ah. I really wish that wasn't the case. Like, that's upsetting. That's the, like, fourth time we've seen him, and I've had to kill him because it's a multi-stage room. Like, he just shouldn't count as an enemy. Like, it should just be an NPC that I can shoot. Like, that's tagged bad. They need to fix that, because it's not fair. You know, normally I'm not, like, super big on, like, oh, the game needs to be changed, but that in particular needs to get changed, because, like, it's one thing for there to be, like, characters that I've never seen before. The other secret character is the robot. I really want the robot. I know how to get the robot. The robot requires me to do, like, a series of things that I'm probably going to devote, like, a series of episodes to doing because they take a while. But that guy, I just need to not kill him on a room. But it's impossible sometimes. Like, in order to progress in the video game, I need to kill him. And, like, that's not fair. Like, progression for, like, a secret character isn't important. Like, it's not something that, like, you know, I need to, like, I don't need to unlock the secret character to progress, but I shouldn't have to stop, I shouldn't be punished for wanting to do that. Does that make sense? Like, It's one thing to, like, handicap myself, like, trying to, like, you know, buy the prime primer. Spend 110 credits on the first floor, buy the prime primer. Ooh, Maiden Shield. Super good. You know what? I will give up the proxy mine for that, and I will use the lock picks to unlock, try to unlock this other chest over here. If you're wondering, yeah, I don't like the, I actually just don't like the proxy mine at all. Ooh, Molotov gun. Molotov gun, not bad. We don't have angry bullets this time, so hopefully it'll be better than we're used to. And I'm hoping that we fight, okay, worthless on this boss. Got it. Fantastic. Love it. I love it. I like it. I love it a lot. But we're doing fine. You know, if we can get mastery on Gorgon, we'll be in such a good position that I'll be pretty pleased about it. It's not that hard to get mastery on Gorgon. You just sort of got to keep your wits about you while you're fighting her. The hardest attacks she has are this one and you know what? We'll just go ahead and blank because I started getting a little nervous there. It's that one and the twin Gatling assault. The spinning one's not hard to dodge. You just gotta stay away from the boss a little bit and you'll be fine. This one, we actually need to use blank there because I wasn't close enough to her to dodge that attack at all. Try not to get hit by the Gorgon stare attack. If you get hit by it, you can dodge roll, but you can't fire. And you know, the inverse equation for damage on a room is time spent on room plus one. So, you know, that's not an inverse equation, actually. Damn it. Okay, well, we got hit, so now we just gotta wait for it to wear off before we can fire. Easy peasy. So far, so good. I mean, we've had a couple close calls, but we're doing fine, generally speaking. Shit, I got hit. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. It's because I'm above her. I, like, have trouble, like, registering where the bullets are when I'm above the target that I'm trying to dodge. Ow. Ah. God, I hate that attack. This is a bad showing on the Gorgon. Normally I can get through this without getting hit too much. And I'm not going to blame my weapons. My weapons are fine, actually. Well, they could be better, but they are okay for right now. It was just ghost bullets, shock bullets, bouncy bullets. Interesting. Bouncy bullets are... they're a thing. They're certainly something. I don't know if I like bouncy bullets. I'll be honest. How much is the map? Because I might be interested in going to the secret room. Well, because I'm going to need to buy the map and the blank. It's 50. All of it is garbage. Luckily, we had the Molotov launcher. It sucks that we had to fight the Gorgon, because if we had fought, it's bad against Amalconda, but not that bad against Amalconda. And then the other second floor boss is... I can't remember. Oh my god, that's embarrassing. The Beholster. If we had fought the Beholster, we would have destroyed him with the Molotov launcher. Almost unfair how badly we would have kicked his ass. The Molotov launcher's good. It's a good weapon. I do enjoy it. Especially if you can get people to stand on it for a long period of time. You know, if a slow moving enemy like the Mushroom Men, like, you know, most enemies. It sort of follows the mentality that I have with the fossil gun, right? It's not bad if you can paint the room with it and not get killed yourself by that. Which, don't get me wrong, is very easy to have happen. Like, it's super easy to accidentally, like, you know, paint yourself into a corner with the Molotov launcher or the Molotov launcher and the brain. Go, come on, figure out the word you're looking for. Fossil gun. There we go. The syringe has the same thing. You paint yourself into a corner with the syringe. But, you know, we're fortunate enough that the Molotov launcher at least has, like, a consistent... like, it's not that hard to not get destroyed by your own Molotovs with the Molotov launcher. I've had rooms where I've accidentally painted myself into a corner with it a couple times. The first time I got it during that Amalconda fight, I accidentally, like, painted off a bunch of my... pass to victory, which, you know, wasn't good, obviously. Holy shit! Burning dragon fire. Alright, we're fine. I mean, the trick here is that we just need to make sure that, like, these guys are immune to our Molotov launcher. Well, not immune. It's very difficult to get them hit by it because they leave that trail of goo behind them. But, you know, like, we destroyed all those bullet kin with the Molotov launcher. That's what makes this gun good. It's good, really, really good at crowd control. Like, super good at crowd control. And if you can get people to run into it, then, you know, you're pretty much golden. It's good against big enemies. It's good against small enemies. I think it's only not good against mobile enemies. Or people who are immune to it, I guess. Like, The Will-O-The-Wisps, the, like, fireball guys, those dudes are immune to the Molotov launcher, so it's impossible to kill them with it. I've seen some gun game runs where people have gotten the Molotov launcher on a Will-O-The-Wisp room, and you just can't do anything about it. Like, you just gotta keep firing it until you run out of ammo. And, like, pray not, hope you don't die. But there are tons of enemies in the game that aren't immune, that you'd think would be immune to it, that aren't. Meet Cube Man, because he's, like, floating in the air. You'd imagine that he'd be immune to something on the ground, but he's not. Stuff like that. Right, we got one green chest. I do want to go to Gun Game Man's room over here. The Trick Shot Hallway, or something like that. Depending on what you want to call it, I guess. But we'll be there. We'll get there at some point. So this is an example of a room that isn't directly countered by the Molotov launcher, but it does help a little bit. You basically just put it on the tracks and then the person dies. The slow, horrible death. These dudes aren't immune to the Molotov launcher, if I'm not mistaken. And it's something to do with the way that ground effects are applied to targets. I don't know exactly how in the code of the game that's supposed to work, but, you know. A, because I've never actually seen the code of the game, but B, because, like, I don't know enough about programming to even... It's probably just, like, a trigger region. Like, enemy enters region, they gain the state burning. Something like that. But, you know, I'm not an expert on... I'm not a programming expert. I also don't know what engine this game was built in. I mean, it could be Unity for all I know. Unity can do some weird stuff. No! 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 Damn it. Damn it. I saw our friend Cape Man a second too late there, which, you know, that's on me. Because I'm pretty sure that this room doesn't have multiple waves, it just has the Bullet Kinmen and the Bubble Bop Dragon. Just go ahead and burn that guy alive from the safety of our own home here. Right. Nope, it had multiple waves. That's right, I feel a little vindicated now. Granted, there was no way for me to know if the waves actually would have interfered with Cape Man becoming part of the team here, but, you know, whatever, it's fine. We good. Healing room? Gun Muncher, huh? We will get rid of... Yeah, let's get rid of both of our guns for that. I want something different. The Aura Gunny's terrible, and the Molotov Launcher is... super good until boss fights, and then it's like absolute garbage. The mahogany is worse than both of those guns put together. Oh my god. Like, if you took the negatives from both of those guns, the mahogany is worse than that gun. Jesus Christ. Alright, this sucks. Mistakes were made, clearly. It's alright. The mahogany's not a terrible weapon, it's just... it's the inaccuracy of it. That's the problem. Like, it... so, the nut does explode, and the explosion does destroy bullets. So, that's good. How? Man. Fuck off with that. But if it, like, was consistent and, like, hit targets at, like, a consistent rate, I think I'd be a lot less pissed off about having the mahogany right now. But you can see, like, the acorn goes rogue, like, all the time. And this gun's just not great. The leaves do damage, but they do, like, so little damage that it doesn't really matter in the long run, like, at all. We might actually die. I might actually die here. That would be super embarrassing, actually. Like, I would have to... that would be really embarrassing. especially with how good we've been doing lately. Let's buy the key and the heart, I guess. That feels super dirty. I didn't like doing that at all. Let's do the room, because I feel like there's a chance we can get a better thing out of the room if we do it like this instead. Which, you know, take it or leave it. That's the way that we're doing it now. Okay, how am I gonna do this, dude? I think if I bounce it like that. There we go. Okay. If we bounce there, where the laser is, it'll go up. Then it'll go like there-ish, so I gotta wait for the guy to path. Damn it. Ugh. Well, we got a red chest anyway, so I feel vindicated. And we got the Rube Andine Mark II. Not a bad gun. Not a bad gun. Not one of my favorite weapons in the game, but definitely not... not a bad weapon. Worth 35 credits for certain. And with bouncy bullets, it should be extra bouncy. I wonder... you know, like, it shoots very quickly, and it does pretty decent damage. And it's got a good clip size. But the bounce is actually kind of nice. My reasoning for that is, like, you kind of saw I was shooting around the corner to hit those guys without, like, putting myself at risk. It's super easy to do that with this gun because it bounces kind of crazy, like, all over the place. Which is nice. It's nice. Right. Easy peasy. The nice part, again, is that I am able to fire very quickly. So... the gun does, like, middling damage, but it's very fast, so uncapped fire rates are nice. I wonder if it does more damage the more it bounces. I don't know. There's something I gotta look up. There are a lot of things. Like, every episode I find a new thing that I need to look up so I can know, like, offhandedly how good, like, a thing's gonna be. I think the nice part's that even if I miss, there's a chance that my bullets are gonna hit somebody. That's kind of nice. Jesus. Alright, well, we got hit, but we got health back immediately, so... whatever, whatever. Right, we'll unlock this thing. Nope, didn't work. We got health back for that. Fantastic. I think that's the end of the floor here. Unless there is a secret room. There is, and it had armor in it. Probably not worth one of our only two remaining blanks, but... oh well. Oh well. What do we got? Cannon Balrog. Not a boss that I'm super excited to be fighting, to be honest. Mostly because I don't want to have to deal with it. I've not had a good track record with the Cannon Balrog of late, and, you know, that concept scares me a little bit. There we go. Isn't the doorway strat to our full advantage there? I'm willing to cheese a boss if I'm able to. Video games should not be treated fairly like people. They're video games. The game is stacked against you 99.9% of the time, and if you find a way to make something easier on yourself, you should do it. Unless you're playing a fighting game, in which case, fuck you for spamming Hadoukens from across the map, you jerk. Unless it's, like, you know, part of your strategy, like, you know, you need to chip them down from their last little bit of HP there. Then that's fine. That's reasonable. I can accept that. Really want to go hide, like, super badly here. Just because I don't like this attack. I always get hit on it. I hate this boss, like, a lot. I remember thinking that he used to be the easiest of the bosses on this floor. It was between him and Treadnought. Treadnought used to be super too hard. Because the military bulletkin, the ones with the helmets and the AKs, they used to lead you while you were running around, and that was not fun. What is that? Cool shades? Sunglasses, a bright future. What is that? What do these do? Slows down time during explosions, increases dodge power during explosions. Ooh, that actually makes the mahogany super good, because, like, when it explodes, we get, like, slow, we get time down, and we get to dodge roll better. Which isn't bad. To say the least. Let's go ahead and try to pop open the other chest with our trusty lockpick here. Since I believe it got fully recharged. Fully charged! Hey, it worked. And we got the commando. Oh, okay. That's not bad. I totally forgot we had the shield of the maiden, to be honest. But yeah, that's not bad. The Commando's a good gun. It's really good against bosses. The Rip Andine Mark II was also super good against the boss. It did a number on him. Probably would have been more in my interest to use the Mahogany, because it can't miss super easy against a boss of, you know, Cannonball Rog's size, but whatever. I do wish that this effect, like, didn't have an internal cooldown for the sunglasses. That would make this item, like, pretty legit. Right now it's only sort of legit, but, you know, wouldn't be too bad. Ow. It's not like the slowdown's, like, that strong. It's, like, middlingly good at best. We really need to get, like, homing bullets or something. This would be nice against, like, bosses. Just because, like, I do think that the slowdown helps a little bit. I wish I had some sort of indication for when the next time the sunglasses can activate is. Like, that'd be nice. Just because, like, it happening at what essentially is amounting to random is not helpful. But, you know, whatever. It's fine. It's an item. It's in our arsenal, basically. Cool guys don't look at explosions. They just turn the back and fade away. The nice part's that the Mahogany is an explosive weapon, technically speaking. So it does destroy bullets when you shoot people with it. If we could get something like Greased Cylinder or something that makes us shoot faster, that'd be nice. Something that increases our fire rate a little bit would be primo. Or if we got Hip Holster, that actually would be pretty nice, because then I can fire, reload. Because the reload speed on the Mahogany is actually not too bad. Not too bad. It can get pretty nasty, but, you know, I've seen there are worse reload speeds than the Mahogany's. And the Mahogany's also, like, a hilarious pun, so, you know, I can get into that. Gotcha. Alright, let's grab Rube and Dine. Right, thank God we actually got boosted to dodge roll there, because I'm pretty sure I would have fallen into the hole if I didn't have that. Sentry turret! Alright, fuck you, lockpicks. Portable sentry turret. You guys know my love of little portable sentry man here. The sentry turret's a good item. You drop it down. It's a fire and forget item, which are my favorite kind of items. And if we can get a machine gun type weapon of some caliber, like, if we can get the M16 again, I'll be on board with that. Did we kill, the jammed guy? I think we did. Yes, we did. Okay. Let's grab Mahogany ammo, because it's the one that we're using right now. Mahogany is not great. The problem with it is that it doesn't do good damage. All of its faults, the inaccuracy, all that stuff, could be totally made up for by the fact that it, like, one-shot bulletkin, but it doesn't. You have to hit them with all the leaves in order to one-shot them, which, let's be honest, that's never gonna happen, ever. Like, not consistently, at least. It'll happen. It happens a couple times here and there, but it's not a good weapon, to say the least. Alright, there we go. Gotta make that guy move and get off the fucking ice. There we go. Suck rockets, nerds! Alright, there we go. We're crawling back up on the HP front as well. We got a lot of HP after the Cannon Balrog fight, so I'm feeling a little bit more confident right now at our odds of winning. I was having a little bit of a downward spiral for a second there. I thought we were gonna lose. Everyone's gonna laugh at me. They're all gonna laugh at you! Name that movie. It turned out to be fine. Which, you know, is my favorite thing in the universe, is when it turns out to be fine. When you plan for the worst and it turns out everything's okay. Gotcha. All right. Easy peasy. Easy peasy. We got the Shield of the Maiden and the Portable Turret. We got two items that I actually super duper like. So I'm feeling confident. I just hope... what boss do I not want to fight? I don't want to fight... I guess Wallmonger would probably be the boss that I don't want to fight on this floor right now. Just because, like, I don't think that we'll have a fun time against him. I don't think we'll lose, mind you. Like, I think that'll be fine. but, you know, it would be preferable if I didn't have to worry about it at all. I really need to get a key drop so I can go into the shop. Otherwise, we're gonna be in trouble. Oh, alright, that sucks. This room's, a little nasty. Oop, there you go. Alright, we got through it, though. I normally get hit on trap rooms. I'm actually kind of proud of myself for not getting hit there. Alright. Kill that guy. Red Man's the worst. Because he just steals our bullets. Can't even do his own dirty work. Son of a bitch. Nah, we good. We Gucci. Boom! Alright. Not bad. Not bad. Mahogany, you know, the more I'm using it, the less I'm hating it. I'll be honest. Go ahead and just kill the shit out of this mimic here. This will also add to, we have to kill mimics for the Frightful and Rifle, Frightful and the Grey Mouser fight, which, you know, will be nice. You're just a jerk, that's the only explanation. I keep having to get my helmet and wind up back here locked up. Then you just let me out so you can kick my helmet again. This is madness. Talk to me in the breach next time you are there and watch your damn feet. Alright, fine, bitch. I'll see you later. That's not her fault. I am kicking her helmet into the abyss. That's because I want it, though. It's a nice helmet. High Priest. Alright. Not a bad enemy to be fighting. For certain. Definitely not the easiest boss to be fighting on this floor. I still think that that honor belongs to the Kill Pillars. You know, that being said, it is... Let's get rid of these skulls here. Now we good. We Gucci. We good. Damn it. Alright. No mastery on this boss, that's fine. That was kind of far-flung anyway. But, you know. I would have preferred it if we could have made it happen. But we couldn't. I mean, not from a lack of trying, but just from a lack of capability. It's fine. Take the boss down. Come on. Come on. We got this. The commando's really... It's a great weapon. It also synergizes with the fucking sunglasses. Which is nice. We'll hide in here. While we wait for the pain to pass here. There we go. Alright. Easy peasy. It just does such good damage. Like, it's almost... It's not absurd, but it's getting there. It's borderline. There we go. Alright, not a problem. Took a little bit of damage, but it looks like we're getting a full heart back. So we took both the hits we took, we're getting back right now. Cluster Mine. Cluster Mine is worse than the turret, in my opinion. That was almost bad. My reasoning there being that the turret is fire and forget. So I get to put it down and I don't have to think about it at all anymore, which means I can switch back to the Shield of the Maiden afterward. So, like, we drop the turret, and then I can switch to the Shield of the Maiden immediately. Assuming I remember to do that. I did it once during that, during the High Priest fight, but, you know, I'm only human. It's hard for me to remember all of the tools I have at my disposal all the time. Easy peasy. Let's just do this. Camera. Alright, that took care of that. Camera's still a good weapon. It's one of my more favorable weapons down here on this floor. Let's go ahead and just pop out here for a second. That's cool, the turret is affected by the passive that we pick up. So like it has bouncy bullets right now, which is kinda cool. It's good to know as well, because that makes that That makes the turret literally one of the best active items in the game, because it synergizes with all of the other items that you can pick up in the game. Should I get this guy to roll into the pit here? You know, hitting those guys point blank with it actually is pretty decent, but therein lies the problem with, like, shotgun weapons late in the game, which is that you have to get really close, and getting really close to people is super dangerous. I mean, at every point in the game, it's super dangerous, but it gets more... The further in the game you get, the more dangerous it becomes. Obviously. I guess maybe not obviously. Especially if you're new here. I mean, you know. I talk about, like, a lot of Gungeon strategy, but I don't think I've ever actually made, like, a tutorial video for, like, how to get good scrub. Like, one where I, like, edit it together and stuff. That might be interesting. Let's grab some commando ammo, because I do plan on using the commando judiciously versus the boss. Ow! Alright, gotta get further away from the hammers before they come down. Alright, I hate the hammer room. Hammer room's the worst. I think it'll be my least favorite room in the game until we get down to the new area. Which I do need to retain some health for. Because it is after High Dragon, for the record. Some of you might know what I'm talking about, what I'm on about here, but we'll see. We'll see. I'm gonna, if we sight read it, I'm putting it on the subreddit. It's gonna be really fun. And then the subreddit's gonna be like, oh, you practiced, or you saw somebody play it. And I'm gonna be like, nah, man. My first time. Don't hate. Like a Pringles can full of hate. Once you pop it, you just can't stop hating. God, I hate fucking mahogany so much. It's just not a good gun. It has tons of ammo, but it's just so bad. It's like a really terrible grenade launcher. I would prefer the grenade launcher, for the record, by the way. The grenade launcher has, like, significantly less ammo, but I would totally take... I'd take less ammo for more punch any day of the week. Ow. I rolled right into those bullets. Thought that was a regular red cube, man. It is not. Fucking Snake Plissken Bulletkin. There we go. Alright. Oof. Ooh, down. Alright. We got 106, so we can afford to buy some stuff. I don't know if I need the bullet, but I'm gonna grab the bullet just in case. I know mutation's pretty good. Sucks that there's no keys here, because I would actually buy some keys right now. Plank pistol's also pretty good. Let's buy the mutation. I've never actually used this weapon before. I know it's a beam weapon. That's all I know about it. And I know it kind of looks gross. That's the only other thing I know about it. Oh, that's horrible. Oh, I don't like that at all. Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, that's terrifying. It's pretty good. Oh, God. It paints them red. No, fuck you, Skeleman, go in the pit. Oh, my God, why are you the worst? Oh, and it, like, pushes me around, too. You see that? That's gross. Ah. Oh, man. This is going to be fun. I'm going to use that against the High Dragon, I think. Just keep firing. I mean, I'm hitting all the people in the room, so it's not like... I'm not wasting ammo here. There we go. Let's grab Herb Andine prototype, I think is probably a good one to grab. Really need to get, like, I need, like, keys, and I need, like, a much better setup of weaponry here. So I don't get either. If I don't get either of those, we're gonna be in like a, we're gonna be in serious trouble going forward. Get away from me! Light yourself on fire and die, please. All right, there we go. And we got a blank, and we got more ammo, which we'll probably grab for the mutation, I think. Yeah, that seems good to me. Let's explore the rest of the floor, try to grab more HP. I know that the secret floor that we're going to does not have a shop or anything on it. So this is our last opportunity to really get, like, stuff. Well, we can still get drops and stuff. And we have the Ring of Chest Friendship, which hasn't gone off at all lately, by the way. Super BS on that. Super BS. There we go. Nah, we good. We Gucci. We pushed that jammed guy into the pit, which was very fortunate, because it was a jammed undead bulletkin, and those guys are not fun to play with, because they're tankier than Snake Plissken bulletkin, but they do lead you, and anybody who leads you in this game is a pain in the dick. So suck mahogany. From a nice, rich mahogany. There you go. You know, this gun's, it's not awful, okay? I'm taking back what I said about the mahogany. I think it's like, it might be because it's like a matter of necessity, but I do find myself enjoying the mahogany now that I'm using it. Whether or not that is because I actually enjoy the weapon or because I am forced to use it right now, remains to be seen, but is there any rooms left? All right, we still have a chance to get keys, so let's not destroy the chest yet. We're getting up against it though right now. Oh, gooped in. Oh shit, son, I wish I had held my money then, because I would totally go to gooped in, because he's got, I want to check out the abyssal tentacle, and he's got duct tape. And duct tape can be super good if we can get it to happen correctly. There you go. Kill that guy. Just point blank him with the mahogany at every opportunity. I blew myself up. Right, nah, he's dead. I got hit twice on this room so far. Just because I just realized the room's not over yet. Right, there we go. Ooh, dog! Three down. That was close. Let's grab this. Mahogany's got so much ammo and it fires so slowly that, like, I'm not inclined to give it ammo if I don't need to. Like, if all of my other guns were full or nearly full, I probably would. But it just fires so slowly, I don't feel the need to, like, put ammo in this thing ever. Oh, brown chest. With table tech. Table tech sight. You know how much I love tables. Look at all these tables on these rooms that I've been on lately. Shit, man. Table techs are so bad. Don't waste your money on them, man. Like, I might come around on the amulets, because they do give you extra blanks per floor, but don't waste your money on table techs, man. They're so bad. They're so bad. Why can't we get more chests? I want more chests. Like, I literally bought that ring on the first floor, and we haven't received a single extra chest this entire time. That's frustrating. Okay, well, where's my sidearm? I guess we'll just shoot this apart and try to grab some HP out of it. Considering that there is nothing I can do about trying to get extra stuff. There's no keys on the floor. I can't buy any from Goopton, and the blacksmith lady doesn't have any either, so. There we go. We got one extra heart out of it. Let's go back to Goopton real quick and see if we can afford either of those two items. I think they were both 90, though. So, we might be able to come back after the high dragon and buy some stuff. Which would I be interested in? Abyssal tentacle or duct tape? I don't know. Probably duct tape. I'd probably duct tape. Probably the. I don't know. It'd probably be the camera and the fucking commando together. That'd probably be the best combination. They both have 4 ammo and a clip, which, you know, is good. We'll just hang out here for a minute. Drop the turret down, pull out the shield of the maiden here. Just use a blank, because why not? Ow. Well, okay. They got hit, which sucks, but whatever. It's fine. Totally fine. Roll! I never noticed the little bullets that fly off of the rocket that this guy shoots, like the RPG round that the High Dragon shoots. We'll drop the turret after this attack is over. There's an explosion of some caliber. I'm not sure what caused that, to be honest. Go ahead and get rid of that guy. Ow. How much HP do I have? 2 HP left? Oh, that's not good. This is not good. Because unlike all the other times I've killed this guy where I've had, like, no HP left, I actually have, like, elsewhere to be this time. Which, you know, isn't great. There we go. All right. We're still in trouble, mind you. We're still in a lot of trouble, mind you. But we're in a lot less trouble right now than normal, which is good. I also have the Shield of the Maiden. Don't forget about that, Brain. No promises, boss. Oh, come on. Get him again. Get him one more time. There we go. All right. I also give a Shield of the Maiden back, which again is bueno. Super bueno. Happy about this. Super good. Okie dokie. Ah, shit. Well, okay, that puts us down to half a heart. Get hit again, we die. Again, like, major concern is that we have another area to go to after this, which is not boding well at all. Let's crack open this can of Coke while we wait here for a second. Alright. It sprayed all over my keyboard. Oh no. Keyboard, please. Stop it. I need you to not be wet. There we go. Alright. Not a problem. Oh, I'll use Shield of the Maiden. Oops. Shoo! Oh, excuse me. Alright. I don't know. I guess we'll go down to the... We'll go down to the thing and see what's up. Hey, there it is. Whee! Ooh, that was spooky. Alright. So, here we are, the final challenge of the game. If you've ever played Spelunky, this is Bullet Hell. The final area of the game. And an area that I've only ever seen once. From a guy that I, from Northern Lion, played him. It was on, like, one of his more recent episodes. Luckily, we have a series of bullets, or weapons, that I do consider to be pretty top tier, for a floor that I've never seen before, so. You know, having the commandos kind of nice. We're able to kill people from a distance, which is nice. We're trying to clear, so there are no shops, and there are no chests on this floor. So we need to get out of here as quickly as possible. A, because the enemies here are a fucking monster factory. They will kill me. You know, they're not terribly complicated, but they're the hardest enemies in the game. Okay. There are shot grubs and shit down here, which just killed me. Alright. Well, we made it to Bullet Hell. So, yeah, that's gonna do it on this episode. Yeah, we got killed by a shot grub. So, yeah, that's going to do it for this episode. So thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw, let me know. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on when I post more videos. We made that. That's actually really quick. It was a 52-minute run. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. It helps the channel grow. It helps you out a great deal. Try to spread the word, you know. Tell your friends. Tell your family. Tell other people. I don't know. I want to try to expand the channel. I think if we get to 100 subs by some point this year, that'd be nice. I'd be pretty hyped about it. Because then we get a tiny URL and I can stop. I can actually, like, send my link to people. That'd be pretty dope. But with that, thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!